I've just received the email about whether I've gotten the job as commissioner.
Well, from the look on my face, I'm sure you can guess what it says.
No! We have no idea at all! Just tell us, you monster!
Really? No one noticed the slight tension in my labial, commissioner? My lips, I'm smiling.
Wait, you're smiling?
Wait, we're allowed to say labia again?
Wait, you got it?
I got it.
Labia?
Commissioner Raymond Holt.
Labia?
You gotta stop right now, Hitchcock.
We need to celebrate.
Ooh!
We need music. Ooh! I brought a Jock Jam CD for the wedding!
Oh, we didn't talk about that.
It was gonna be a surprise. Our first dance was gonna be at a Tootsie Roll.
Oh, no, we didn't get to do it.
I know! All right, nobody move. I'm gonna go get the CD.
I wanna thank you all. What an incredible moment. 30 years of struggle and sacrifice, but it was worth it because I finally get to read the 10 words I've longed to hear. Raymond Holt, you are not the... Oops, I misread the email. Didn't see the not.
So...
I will not be the new commissioner.
Y'all ready for this?
Jerk Germ! Woo! Why is no one else dancing? Did I miss something? Feels like I missed something. I'm just gonna keep going until someone tells me to stop.
Stop, Jake.
All right!
So, two keys, huh? That's a lot of snow.
Yeah, if you can't handle it, we're happy to find someone who can.
Don't worry about me, friend. I can handle it. Marissa, baby. Go get our guests something to drink, would you?
We don't want a drink.
What is this, a social call?
It's not a tea party.
We look like five-year-old girls to you.
Gentlemen, please. Have some patience. Two keys. Pure as a Catholic schoolgirl. Did you bring the cash?
Oh, we brought something much better than cash.
What's that?
Our guns.
NYPD, you're under arrest!
Boss man's gone. Where'd he go? Thank you, kind little lady.
Gio Costa, you're under arrest.
You want that drink now, Hitchcock?
Don't mind if I do, Scully.
Don't mind if I do.
Attention squad, put your hands together for the long-anticipated reunion of...
DDC!
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 Put a J with a G.
You get DDC!
The gas face.
What the hell is the DDC?
I don't know, but I love it.
The DDC is the dope.
Denim.
Crew. Our 20-year high school reunion is tonight, and the party is 90s themed, so we're dressing the way we did back then, aka hella fresh.
Can't wait to see everyone we graduated with and lie to them about what I've been up to for my own amusement. It's gonna be Fib City, population. Gina Clooney.
But Jake, how could you be excited to return to your high school? The scene of... Tattlegate.
What's Tattlegate? Why haven't I heard anything about it?
It was junior year, and Jake was riding high.
Charles, no one wants to hear this story. From you, it was junior year, and Jake was riding high. Sophomore year was rough, but now I was back with a hot new look, an earring and long hair.
Which was my look, and he just copied it.
And it worked. I was finally cool and becoming friends with the most popular kid in school. Brandon Bliss.
Dope name. Sounds hot.
He was hot, Rosa.
For the record, he could barely read.
He didn't have to read, Gina. He lost his virginity when he was 12 years old.
Which is horrifying.
But it wasn't back then. Back then, it was... everything. He asked me to ditch class one day with him and his buddies, steal a school van, and go get drunk at his parents' cabin. But the day before we were supposed to go, someone ratted Brandon out, and he got suspended. He thought I was the one who told, and from that day forward, everyone called me the Tattler.
Tattler. It's a sexy nickname.
It was not a sexy nickname. It was a scarlet letter, and it ruined my senior year. But luckily, I'm over all that now.
Not me. I'm gonna go to this reunion tonight and kick Brandon Bliss in the butthole.
Horrifying. But that won't be necessary, Charles, for my awesome life will do the butthole kicking this eve. I've got a sweet job and a super smart, incredible wife. Tonight's gonna be awesome, right, Gina?
Damn straight.
A-dee-dee.
See?
A-dee-dee.
See?
A-dee-dee.
See?
All right, Jeffers, what's this meeting all about? I've got a full workload today.
I didn't call it. I thought you did.
What? I did no such thing.
So if neither of you called it, then who did? Okay, just stay here. Wow, I can't believe I executed that to perfection.
That was amazing.
Gina, what's this all about?
I wanted to make one final grand entrance.
Final? What do you mean?
I've decided to leave the 99, which is why...
Oh, okay.
I'm handing in my 2 weeks' notice.
I don't understand. What are you gonna do?
I'm not sure, but Jake convinced me it was time to start a new chapter. It was time to spread my wings and fly. I'm an angel. I'm an angel. I'm an angel.
This is crazy. I can't imagine the 99 without you.
Don't worry, I have a parting gift for all of you. I printed Time for Gina's Opinion hoodies for you with your names on them. Oh, there you go.
Oh, that's fun. So, like, Time for Jake's Opinion?
What are you, insane? No, it says Time for Gina's Opinion in large text on the back, and then your names are stitched really tiny on the front.
Ah.
I had to guess at some of the spellings.
Arnie?
But that's not all. Over the next 2 weeks, I will be leaving each of you with a signature Gina moment. Something so shocking that it will stay with you for the rest of your lives. Much like this interpretive dance piece entitled The Lenexit. This dance will be performed in 4 movements, each one expressing one aspect of my personality.
Awesome. Was that the first movement?
What, are you crazy? No, that's the warm-up. Each movement is 45 minutes.
Oh, damn.
Hit it!
Peralta, looks like an old friend of yours is back in town.
Who? That guy Neil that you bunked with at sleepaway camp?
Ah, Neil from camp was the best. He could pick up a milk carton with his butt cheeks. He was so funny.
You know who else was funny? Bill Cosby.
Charles, will you relax? You're gonna love Neil.
It's not Neil. Why would it be Neil? It's Doug Judy.
Right, someone we all know in a police capacity. That makes more sense.
Someone's using his signature move to steal cars, plugging into the OBD port and reprogramming the immobilizer module.
That's Doug Judy's MO, but it's not him. He told me he went legit.
That's what he told you last time, too, before he screwed you over.
Yeah, but he returned the diamonds to me eventually, and it turned out that was the only way to get Giggle Pig off the streets. Wait, I may be confusing our adventures. What year was the cruise? The
dude's a criminal. People don't change.
Ever heard of Bruce Banner, the Incredible Hulk? You might want to talk to his shirts and pants about people not changing.
Well, I want to ask Doug Judy some questions. You have his number?
I always make contact through his mom. I'll put you in touch with her, but remember, she thinks I'm his assistant, Mangy Carl, and he's a famous architect who's designing LeBron James' new school for black astronauts.
Hello? Mrs. Judy? I'm looking for your son, the architect. Yes, I'm from Black NASA. Oh, my. I didn't know. I understand. Goodbye. So, Doug Judy will not be coming in.
What? Why not? Oh, I see. He is dead.
Hey, sorry I'm late. The coffee guy was
assaulting your head? What is going on up there?
Is it bad?
Before I answer that question, do you currently have a knife on you?
Yeah, several.
Then I love it. It really is hair. It's bad, Rosa. You look like Edna from The Incredibles. I'm sorry, don't stab me.
My girlfriend Jocelyn's been practicing a bunch of different hairstyles on me. She's in cosmetology school.
Is she
passing? Honestly, I don't know.
Well, let's get into this murder. I'm hoping it's a dope one.
Mamma mia, that's a bloody pizza pie.
No, it's okay, I can say that. I'm half Italian.
It's not the problem I had with it.
Detectives, the vacuum was running when we got here. Smeared blood across the entire apartment.
Does it dope enough for you?
I mean, it's a bloody robot, Rosa. It's clearly a good start, but it's gonna take more than that to be certified as dope. Who's the Vic?
Name is Andrew Adams.
Kind of a boring name, not dope.
He's an investigative reporter.
Dope? What was he investigating?
Chicken farming.
A sharp turn away from dopeness, but who found the body?
His boss called the cops when he didn't show up to work, so he was found by Officer Daryl.
Officer Daryl? You are seriously undoping this. You got anything else for me? Jen?
The apartment was locked from the inside.
Mysterious. Dope.
And the alarm system was still armed.
Dope, 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 dope. So hard to solve.
Any surveillance cameras?
Oh, yeah. Tons of them. We checked them.
It's too easy.
But no one was seen going in or out. So whoever did this was a ghost.
Yes, a ghost. Oh, I officially declare this case dope! Another cold brew? Don't mind if I cold do. Nailed it. I am loving this machine that Charles brought in.
It is nice. The trick is to let the coffee warm up the room temperature. I'm already on my second cup.
This is my third.
Stop! You're drinking too much!
Whoa, what's going on? Charles, why are you talking so slow?
I'm not. I'm normal. We're all normal.
Oh my God, if you're not going slow, that means we're going faster. Are we going fast? Can anyone tell if we're going fast?
I don't think we're going fast at all in any way whatsoever. I feel like we're going slow in every way whatsoever. Captain, how do you feel?
Great, excellent, amazing. I feel better than I've ever felt in a moment in my entire life.
So we're all fine.
Yep.
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 Yep. Yep. Yep. Yep. Yep. Yep. Yep. Yep. Yep. Yep. Yep. Yep.
And now on to new business. Peralta, there's a case I'd like you to handle. Methodist Hospital called this morning. Apparently, a 38-year-old investment banker was admitted last night with a broken penis. It looks like
Whoa. There's a finance guy with a broken dong. Methinks some Wolf of Wall Street style shenanigans have taken place this day. Anyone care to wager a guess as to how this happened?
Yeah, I bet he dipped it in a pile of cocaine, got it real numb, and then hit a croquet ball with it.
Totally possible.
He probably sat on
it. So it got under his butt.
Happens all the time.
Sure do.
Oh, you guys are horrible. And you're wrong, because he was clearly driving his Bentley naked, tried to pee out the window, and was then struck by a goose on the wang. Is that what happened, sir? Was he struck by a goose?
He was actually struck by a female co-worker who claims he attempted to sexually assault her.
I really wish you had stopped us before we started guessing.
I'm not responsible for that. Now, due to the sensitive subject matter, I think it makes sense to partner Peralta with...
Me? Because I'm the best at sex?
No, Hitchcock. In fact, you know what? This isn't your week. Why don't you take a few days off?
Sweet! Have fun working, cucks!
What?
Captain, I'd like to work the case with Jake. I have the time. I'm 3 weeks ahead on my paperwork.
Fine. Santiago and Peralta, talk to both parties. Get to the bottom of this broken penis.
Wait. I just want to say I think it's sad that we as a society can no longer laugh at the phrase broken penis. And it is my dream that we one day shall again. Team Broken Penis on three. One, two, three.
Broken penis!
Yeah, I probably should have seen that coming. Sir, you wanted to see me?
Yes, I have an assignment for you. I'm afraid it's not a pleasant one.
Oh, my God. Please tell me it's not.
Yes. It's Hitchcock-related.
Son of a bitch.
Detective Hitchcock is set to testify in court this afternoon. It's an important case, and I'd rather not get another call from the DA saying he showed up, quote, covered in condiments, unquote.
So you want me to keep Hitchcock from spilling on himself for the rest of the day? We both know that's impossible.
I'm counting on you.
I won't do it.
There's nobody else I trust.
What you're asking is insane.
I'm not asking.
It's a suicide mission.
Then prepare for death.
You've lost your mind.
This is a direct order, Detective. Get in line.
Hey. You guys startled Hitchcock. He spilled 2 full jars of spaghetti sauce on himself.
Thanks a lot, fellas.
So I told Nikolaj, who cares if you're bad at skateboarding? When you grow up, nobody thinks skateboarders are cool. What's cool is hemming your own pants.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
Jake, you seem distracted. You're agreeing with everything I say. We should go on a month-long couples vacation. You, Amy, me, and my dad.
Yeah, fine, whatever.
And we should get matching hats that say Best Bud 1 and Best Bud 2. We should wear them all the time.
For sure. Look, Charles, don't look behind you, but I think we're being followed. I saw this guy when we were leaving the precinct, then he was in line at lunch, and now he's right behind us.
Is it someone you arrested?
I don't recognize him, but judging by the head-to-toe denim, I'd say he's either not American or deeply American. I'm thinking Ukraine or Kentucky.
Well, should we call it in?
No, I've got a better idea. Hi there. Who are you and why are you following me?
I'm not following you. I come for Charles Boyle.
Hey! Hands where we can see him.
Chill out, bro. It's not gun. It's just, it's a toy. No shoot, pretty please. It's gift for Nikolaj.
Nikolaj? How do you know Charles's son?
My name is Gintars from Latvia. I am Nikolaj's birth father.
Oh, Nikolaj's birth father, who I never hoped to meet. Very cool.
Bottles. Boil. Bullpen.
What are you?
Bottles. Boil. Bullpen. Bowling. Behold, Brooklyn buddies. Boil. Bullpen. Bottle. Bowling.
Beautiful.
Be brave, bro. Be brave. Bowl. Title of your sex tape. Nailed it. So, have you ever heard of a guy named Bruno Rojas?
Yeah, big guy in the Colombian cartel, right?
He was, until he got shot in the chest yesterday by his top lieutenant. Apparently, the bullet went straight through his nipple.
Whoa, nature's bullseye.
Oh my God, I love the way your brain works. Anyways, he's in a coma now, and Captain Holt thinks if I'm here when he wakes up, I can get him to talk.
So what'd you call me for?
Because I need a partner.
What about them?
Oh, we're not here for work. I brought Scully in because he needs some medical tests.
Yeah, I'm here all the time. I'm kind of the mayor of this place. Sure, old baby, you got a fresh bag for me?
Saving you the biggest one, Scully.
You're too good to me. Anyway, I'll see you guys around. Dan, the enema man.
Guess it's kind of nice to see Scully in his element.
Woo!
Jake, I can't stay here with you. I have so much on my plate at work.
Yeah, so do I. I mean, I've been pulling double shifts nonstop, but we haven't really gotten to hang out in almost a month. Our anniversary is coming up, and we don't even have anything planned.
I know, but we talked about this. We're gonna take a trip as soon as we have time, I promise.
Just like you promised we would see the Bumblebee movie?
I didn't promise that. I believe what I said was, isn't that a kid's movie?
Yeah, and I believe what I said was, it's for teens. Look, I get that you can't take any time off from work, but this is a loophole. It's still work. You know, we can hang out here and chat and catch up and laugh, and technically we'll be doing our jobs. I call it a casecation. Casecation, all I ever wanted.
Ooh.
Casecation had to get away.
Babe, this is so sweet, but do you honestly think that Holt's gonna let me just hang out here with you indefinitely?
Yes, just tell him I need supervision. I've spent the last 6 years building up a reputation as an irresponsible goof for this very moment.
That is ridiculous. Holt respects you.
Does he, though?
Hello, you've reached the office of Raymond Holt. I can come to the phone right now.
Hey, sir, I'm just here at the hospital with Jake, and I think he could use some...
Oversight? Agreed.
So?
Casecation, all I ever wanted.
I'm here. You can start the meeting now.
The meeting is over. You're late. You missed roll call and the tutorial on using the new copier. 6 years, and no matter how hard I try, I still can't get you to understand the importance of being punctual.
Maybe you should just give up and accept me for who I am?
No, I will break you right now.
Ow.
While you were out being tardy, I was hard at work devising a special punishment. I've crafted an intricate, personal high five with everyone in this office except you.
What? But you hate high fives.
Yes, every minute of it was hell. But it'll be worse for you. Squad, dismissed. Goodbye, Diaz.
Salute into a fanny waggle.
Goodbye, Boyle.
Oh, this snake charmer.
Goodbye, Jeffords.
That's a butt bump.
Goodbye, Santiago.
Double fist bump, reverse explosion into a Pete Townsend strum.
All right, that was terrible, but it's over now, and I made it through.
Goodbye, Leonard from Xerox.
What? No. The copy guy? So you guys are gonna tie up the only microwave for 20 minutes to make a frozen lasagna? Ballsy.
You ignorant loser. First of all, it's not just a frozen lasagna. It's a mamma maglione's.
Second of all, it's gonna take 21 and a half minutes. The box says 20, but we know better than the box.
You see, this microwave is a Kitchen Pro Max.
Bit of a lightweight.
It's only 1.2 kilowatts.
Fine for popcorn.
But we're talking about a mamma maglione's here.
It takes a lot to get mama hot.
She's a real size queen.
Well, that started out fun, and here we are at our normal ending place, disgusting.
Uh-oh. Guys, we have a major problem here. No garlic bread.
Okay, we need to stay calm. Let's think. The garlic bread needs to go in the toaster oven with 8 minutes left on the lasagna. Maybe we could run down to the corner store and make it in time.
That just gives us 12 minutes to go to a place and come back.
Mama Maglione.
We have to go now!
Okay, well, good luck with that, weirdos.
Stupid piece of crap.
Rosa, come on. You can't break a mouse in half. Oh, wow, you did. Scary. You really earned your rep.
Stupid internet. The network's been down all morning, and my girlfriend...
Jocelyn.
Right, she's leaving town for 2 weeks.
Oh, is Jocelyn leaving town? Where is Jocelyn going?
Dude, you forgot her name one time. It's not a big deal. You don't have to keep proving you remember it.
That's not what's happening here. I'm just saying it a lot because she's so important to me.
Okay, what's her last name?
Uh-oh.
Mm-hmm. It's Price.
Right.
She's leaving town for 2 weeks. I want to send flowers to her hotel room.
Oh, that's sweet.
I wish Amy would send me flowers.
Why is it taking Holt and this IT guy so long to fix the internet? One police plaza sent him an hour ago.
Huh. Why does Holt look so worried?
What are you talking about? He looks exactly like he always does.
To you, perhaps. But I finally learned how to read his emotions. His lips are slightly pursed, and he's blinking at 8-second intervals as opposed to his normal 10. Oh my god. He's having a meltdown.
Meltdown seems excessive.
No, it's a meltdown. Mark my words. Hey there, Captain. Everything okay?
No, I'm having a meltdown.
Rob, sounds amazing.
Thanks, it was a lot of work.
This is Sergeant Knox.
From Cyber Operations.
He's discovered the reason for our network issues. A hacker is attempting to break into our servers.
Not all of them, just the Lacme server.
Well, that's good.
No, Captain Holt's nostril just twitched. It's bad.
It's devastating.
Props again.
Thanks again.
The Lacme server holds clearance protected information, including the names of our undercover agents. If it's compromised, people could lose their lives.
Okay, but isn't the server secure?
Yes, but the hacker's already used an ARP to resolve the host name with the DNS server.
Uh-huh. ARP, DNS, totally following what you're saying.
Right now, they're trying to get root access by connecting the OSI network to the data link.
You know, I'm a bit of a computer nerd myself, but could you maybe dumb it down a bit for my friends here?
They're almost through our defenses. If we can't stop them, they'll be inside of our server in 19 minutes.
Mamma Maglione. Confucius, Buddha, Jesus. They all brought light to darkness, but none of them had 1 million subscribers, so...
They can't suck it!
Your videos changed my life.
Changed my life!
You are my queen.
Stai cambiando il mundo!
No, Italian girl. We are changing the world.
For we are the G-Hive. And today, we are celebrating our 1 millionth subscriber.
Over 1 million people are living their lives according to the Gina Mandments.
They're like the Ten Commandments, only there's more and they're better.
I would now like to express my gratitude the best way I know how, through song.
Gratitude.
Hey, it's the best day of the year. Happy Cinco de Mayo.
I don't think you're allowed to wear a poncho at work, Hitchcock.
Let's fiesta!
Oh, you got a band.
Stop! No trumpets, not today! My head is killing me.
Hit the tequila a little early, huh?
I'm not hungover, Hitchcock. I got a tension headache. I got the lieutenant's exam tonight. I'm stress eating like crazy. I had 10 hard-boiled egg yolks this morning.
Gross.
You're having a high-grade pre-test freakout? I've been there. March 13th, 2001. AP Calc test.
Ames, I hate to cut you off, but we all know where this story's going.
Oh, yeah? You know that I crapped my pants in the middle of the test?
Oh, my God, no. I thought you were just gonna say you got a B+ or something.
More like a BM.
Nice.
Come on! Now Terry's worried about his test and his bowel.
What you need, Sergeant, is to distract yourself. NPR has a riveting 6-hour interview with Eileen Moon Myers.
Nobody knows who that is.
Nobody knows the associate principal cellist in the New York Philharmonic? Okay.
Wait, I've got it. I know how to distract Terry. Captain, remember how you canceled the last Halloween heist because there was that emergency gas line explosion and you said we had to help out?
Yes. I also remember you refusing to believe the explosion was real.
Go back to acting school, buddy. You're way overselling the pain here.
No one's buying it.
Well, it's not like I was the only one who thought it was fake.
And the Oscar goes to Rents.
You said that we should reschedule the heist for another day, so... why not today? To help distract Terry.
Yes, and I would love to defend my crown after I destroyed you all last year.
Well, I mean, the proposal was all part of my plan.
All I remember is you bowing to me on your knees.
Yeah, I was asking you to marry me.
Well, you look like a fool.
Neither of you won because Jake swapped out the real championship cummerbund
belt
for the treacly proposal one.
Well, I thought everyone loved that I used the heist to do the proposal.
You were wrong. Everyone hated it. But it helped me win. During your engagement celebration, I snuck back and found the original cummerbund.
Belt.
It's hanging up in my living room at home.
I never thought I'd say this, but enough foreplay. Are we heisting or not?
Yes.
Of course.
Wait, I will only do this under one condition. Sergeant Jeffords agrees that this will help his nerves.
Yeah, I mean, I would like to take my mind off the test, and maybe I'll win this year.
The heist is already working. Sergeant Jeffords has recovered his sense of humor.
Hey.
All right, but for real, though, are we doing this?
We're doing this!
Heist!
Heist!
It's a Cinco de Mayo heist!
A Cinco de Mayo heist makes just as much sense as Halloween. Let's do it! Guys, I have a great idea for a prank. Before Holt comes in, I'm gonna put ink on the podium where he puts his hands.
I don't think he'll fall for that.
I did. How? I haven't even opened this yet.
I guess it's unrelated.
Captain Holt hates pranks. This is gonna backfire, man.
Ugh, fine, I'll tone it down. I'll move his podium a foot to the left.
What? He'll be so angry.
Okay, 5 inches.
Five?
Three?
Three.
One?
One?
All right, I'll move it a half inch.
Fine, it's your funeral.
Oh my God. Worst prank ever. So stupid, Holt's not even gonna notice.
Good morning. You guys, the podium is... You're crazy! How did you pull this off?
Gentlemen, may I present to you the Suicide Squad.
Hang on there, genius. You want us, your enemies, to help you bring down Commissioner Kelly?
You guys consider me your enemy? You're some of my best friends. We haven't talked to you in like 3 years, CJ. Wait, yeah, I'm thinking of different guys.
Oh, Raymond. That you came to me to ask for help shows how much you've matured. You know what else shows how much you've matured? Your withered face.
Now I know why you refer to this as a Suicide Squad, Peralta, because I already want to kill myself.
Why don't you wait a week? You'll probably die of old age.
The only way I'm gonna die is if you touch me with one of your bony fingers and drag me across the River Styx, you Reaper.
Ah, wonderful. Very creative. Look, John Kelly has to be stopped. He's spying on civilians. It's unconstitutional and it's wrong.
Please, do you think any one of these jackals cares about what's right or wrong?
I'll help.
See, sir, there is good in every person.
But I want it to be known as for selfish reasons.
Why would you want that to be known?
Because I never met CJ before, and I want him to think that I'm cool.
It's working. I mean, I love how you're taking over the room.
Yeah, that's awesome.
You know, I actually wouldn't mind getting rid of John Kelly either. That guy makes up so many dumb rules. He told me I couldn't eat raw chicken.
And you think a new commissioner will?
Yeah, he's already on board, so yes, a new commissioner would let you eat raw chicken for whatever reason.
It's healthier.
It sure is, Siege.
And what do you hope to get out of this, Madeline? Let me guess. Revenge on Dorothy for killing your sister.
I want the same as you, Raymond. I think what John Kelly is doing is terrible.
Yes, well said, Wunsch. So we're all on board. This is exciting. Let's bring it in, huh? Suicide Squad on three. Ready? One, two.
I don't touch other dudes' hands.
Whose hand is sticky?
Oh, that might be me. I ate a popsicle earlier.
It's probably Madeline. Cockroaches release a mucus-like secretion.
You would know about roaches, you roach.
And three, Suicide Squad!